My name is Alexandra, and I studied how DNA cruciforms control virulence in the bacterial species Vibrio parahaemolyticus. In the summer, many people enjoy eating fresh shellfish such as oysters. As delicious as they are, there are always a few unfortunate people that get sick from eating them. This food poisoning is most likely caused by a bacterium called Vibrio parahaemolyticus. Vibrio parahaemolyticus is a gram-negative bacterium that inhabits warm marine and estuarine environments across the globe. They have several tools that allow themselves to infect a host and cause disease. One of these tools is a type 3 secretion system, a process that allows the bacteria to inject harmful proteins and toxins into the host cell, which eventually kills it. Currently, the Thomas Lab is studying if a DNA cruciform plays a role in controlling the production of the type 3 secretion system 1. DNA cruciforms are structures that can form from specific DNA sequences called inverted repeats and are important regulators of many biological processes. Together, the lab hypothesized that a DNA cruciform regulates the type 3 secretion system based on the presence of an inverted repeat sequence in a vital region of the DNA for type 3 secretion system 1 function. We think that the system only turns on when the DNA cruciform is not present. We suspect that bacterial proteins play a part in disassembling the cruciform. We took this segment of DNA and produced several mutants to see what happens to the virulence of the bacteria once we alter the DNA sequence of the cruciform. We then performed a cell death assay by infecting human cells with these mutants. The sequences circled in red on the table are the inverted repeats that would come together to form a cruciform. The mutants were designed to change the bases that are thought to be involved in cruciform formation. The numbers in the graph indicate the percentage of human cells dead after a 4-hour infection. As expected, the unmodified Vibrio had the highest cell death. In contrast, we found that most mutants were significantly deficient for cell killing, indicating that the cruciform DNA region plays a vital part in regulating type 3 secretion system 1 biogenesis. These results allow us to pursue more questions such as, do the mutants affect the cruciform formation, or do they affect the proteins that bind to the inverted repeats? In summary, I was able to investigate if a DNA cruciform helps regulate the genetic expression of the type 3 secretion system in Vibrio parahaemolyticus. This was done by infecting human cells with Vibrio mutants. We found that the mutation significantly impacted the Vibrio's efficiency of cell killing. However, we still need to determine how the mutations affected the activation or inactivation of the type 3 secretion system 1. This research is important because once we understand more about how this system works, we can determine ways to treat patients with Vibrio food poisoning more efficiently. Research shows that Vibrio numbers increase along with sea surface temperature, and with ocean waters across the globe getting warmer, there will likely be more Vibrio shellfish contamination. I would just quickly like to thank the David and Faye Sobey Foundation for the Summer Research Award and Dr. Nikhil Thomas from the Microbiology and Immunology Department for supporting my work in his lab this summer. Thank you.